The main symptoms of inflammatory bowel disease are diarrhea. This is often associated with blood, pus and mucus. Patients can get cramping abdominal pain. This is around the time they're opening their bowels. They can feel generally tired and unwell. This could be due to the disease being active, possibly as a side effect of the medication, or just simply waking up in the middle of the night on a regular basis to go to the toilet. They may lose their appetite and have weight loss. This could be because they're not eating enough or not absorbing enough nutrients from their food because of inflammation in the bowel. They can just generally feel unwell, feel feverish. They may develop anemia, especially if they are going to the toilet and having lots of bleeding. And occasionally some patients may develop painful tiny ulcers in the mouth called aphthous ulcers. And inflammatory bowel disease can also affect other parts of the body. It can cause arthritis, especially in the joints in the arms, legs and back. It can cause rashes, something called erythema nodosum and pyoderma gangrenosum. And it can also affect your eyes. A very common condition called episcleritis can occur, which is when the outer lining of the eye becomes inflamed, red and painful. There are certain recognized risk factors for inflammatory bowel disease. Living in a Western society is a risk factor. This could be due to lifestyle choices such as diet, possibly environmental pollution. However, recently there has been an increase in incidence of inflammatory bowel disease, especially in Asia, again, possibly related to lifestyle changes such as diet. Being young is a risk factor. However, there is also increased incidence of inflammatory bowel disease towards later stages of life. People don't know exactly why this is. Having a family history of inflammatory bowel disease significantly increases the risk of you developing the condition. Smoking affects ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease differently. It is a significant risk factor of Crohn's disease and makes the symptoms much worse. However, it is very protective for ulcerative colitis, and ex-smokers are more likely to develop the condition. Certain gut infections are thought to trigger inflammatory bowel disease, such as Campylobacter, Salmonella, and E. coli. It is thought that having your appendix taken out is protective against developing ulcerative colitis. It is thought due to a change in immune system, but people don't know exactly why this happens. There are a range of drugs that are used to treat inflammatory bowel disease. Initially, the treatment is given to heal the inflammation and to bring about remission so that the patient feels better. Following this, the doctor will keep the treatment going so that you don't get any more flare-ups and the disease is under control. This is called maintenance treatment. Obviously, lifestyle choices will also help as well, such as drinking a lot of fluid, especially if you're having lots of fecal loss, avoiding trigger foods and stressful situations. If you have nutritional deficiencies, then you may need some supplementation such as vitamin D, iron supplementation if you're anemic. So this is the mainstay of medical treatment. Occasionally when patients have really bad disease, such as they develop stricture and Crohn's disease, then they may need surgery. The genetic causes of inflammatory bowel disease can be prevented. However, by making lifestyle choices, you can reduce the risk of developing inflammatory bowel disease and also reduce the chance of relapse. This can be done by eating healthily, exercising regularly, and if you've got Crohn's disease, then by stopping smoking. There is no strict individualized plan that patients must follow. However, there are basic principles that will help improve symptoms, especially during a flare, such as having smaller meals, having them more frequently, eating in a nice, relaxed atmosphere, avoiding insoluble fiber, such as bran, vegetable, fruits, etc., and avoiding greasy foods, and avoiding trigger foods. Obviously, this can vary between individual to individual. It is also important to increase the amount of fluid intake, especially water. Try to avoid drinks that contain caffeine, because caffeine is a stimulant and it can rev up the bile and make the diarrhea worse.